what's going on, guys? BDCulture13 here, and welcome back to my, well, we're gonna get started with our Let's Play of Metal Gear Solid 4, Guns of the Patriots. So here we go. Let's do it. And how is everybody doing today in the chats? Hope everybody's doing good. Yeah, I was actually going to, I was actually gonna do this yesterday, but, for some reason my PS3 wasn't reading this disc, so I had to get another used PS3 to see if it would work better, and hopefully it'll be fine. Yeah, I played this one before. Yeah, for some reason my regular PS3 wasn't reading the game, so I had to go out and buy a used one. And, yeah, it's seem to be working fine, so hopefully it does for the rest of the game. I mean, yeah, let's see what happens, Luigi Yoshi. You know, the last time I played this game was, yeah, the last time I played this game didn't have trophy support yet, so it's been a while. Hey, what's up, Chandelier? Enjoying that Mario Maker? I don't know how you did it, dude. I don't know how you did it, man. Hola, Jesus. Sí, sí hablo español. ¿Cómo estás? All right, here we go. Actually, hold on a second. Let me check the settings because I don't think they save. Yeah, they don't save. All right, let me just adjust this real quick. Oops. Set that to fast. Turn on the subtitles as well. Yeah, I actually thought this would save, but no, it didn't. Let me see. Let me adjust the brightness a little bit. Let's leave it right there, I guess. Hopefully, it's not gonna be too bright. All right, here we go. Oh yeah, let's change the channel here. We're gonna watch some TV before we start the game.
Citizen of the world.
I like this channel.
Yeah, well, I never...
Ripped from the comfortable childhood in Canada, thrown into the turbulent waters of adolescence in Kobe, Japan. How did you stay afloat?
You mean in high school? Well, my dad got transferred overseas, and it was a really excellent experience, actually. I was really grateful for it.
Grateful? What is your biggest secret, David?
Pardon me?
You can tell us.
Oh, well, it's not much of a secret, but I have a tattoo of Kobe behind my ear.
Tattoo? Splendid.
Yeah, it's not terribly big.
What are you wearing?
What do you mean?
Why are you here?
Oh, well, I was hoping to promote my new movie. I'm just coming off of the set.
No, David Hayter. Why here, wearing an eye patch?
Oh, the eye patch. This is pretty cool, actually. Gives me real-time information and weather, traffic reports. Actually watching a baseball game as we speak.
Billy, what drives you? What are your dreams?
Well, you know, I'd have to say my dream project...
Let your dreams drive you. A message of hope to today's young people from David Hayter.
I never actually said that.
All right, my show's over. Let me change the channel here. Oh, this looks good.
Surfait. Je suis la mort. attraction irresistible.
Yeah, for those of you guys that don't know, the that first little video that played was it actually included the voice actor of Snake, David Hayter. So that was actually him, for those of you guys that don't know. But alright, start this up.
Nations, ideologies, or ethnicity. It's an endless series of proxy battles fought by mercenaries and machines. War, and its consumption of life, has become a well-oiled machine. War has changed. ID tag soldiers carry ID tag weapons, use ID tag gear. Nanomachines inside their bodies enhance and regulate their abilities. Genetic control, information control, emotion control, battlefield control. Everything is monitored and kept under control. War has changed. The age of deterrence has become the age of control. All in the name of averting catastrophe from weapons of mass destruction. And he who controls the battlefield controls history. War has changed. When the battlefield is under total control, war becomes routine.
Here we go. Well, we're only gonna control Snake for a little bit. I think another cutscene starts afterwards. Alright, oh, wait, there's something right here. Nice! Got a ration already. Sweet. Alright, let's get out of this little spot here.
Where is he? Where'd he go? Get back here, you!
Yeah, it's pretty cool, like how it transitions from a cutscene to like the actual gameplay. What the hell? It does that a lot in this game too.
To make a weapon available for use, ready it by selecting weapons from the menu screen.
What's up, Melvin and Brian? And Vampire Werewolf? Yeah, I don't have the tranquilizer gun yet. Yeah, because I'm gonna try to go for no kills again. I'm gonna try to do that just like I did in Snake Eater. Geckos, come over here.
Head north and try not to run into any geckos along the way.
Yeah, I think this is a good way to go to avoid being seen by those geckos. Oh shit! That's what I thought. I was like, wait, doesn't one drop from somewhere around here? Yeah, if I would have gone out, I probably would have gotten hit there.
Huh.
It's quite an intro. Yeah, let's save our game. Just in case. Just in case anything goes wrong. Alright. Let's continue watching a movie.
Analysis was positive, but the mRNA analysis turned up negative. The wrinkled skin, the hardened arteries. Your early aging symptoms look like classic Werner syndrome. But none of the tests were able to pinpoint the cause.
So?
Well, judging by how rapidly the aging is progressed, I'd say
a year at best, right?
Yeah. Snake, let's try another doctor.
It won't make any difference. I'm not an ordinary man to begin with. Not to mention Fox Dye.
You're right. But we don't know where Naomi is.
Not a colonel anymore, Snake.
I figured the only place I'd see you dressed like that would be at your daughter's wedding. What are you doing these days?
I'm working for an organization under the UN Security Council. The analysis and assessment staff of the PMC Oversight and Inspection Committee.
Yeah, I remember the resolution being passed a few years ago.
Snake, I came across some information in my work.
Huh?
We found him. In the Middle East.
What?
I'll explain along the way. We've got to stop him. Now. Before it's too late.
Liquid's made his move. We've found him.
He's preparing to unleash his insurrection. Liquid is lying in wait in a Middle Eastern war zone. Track him down.
It's not over yet. Or wait, do we start right now, I think? I don't know, I think another cutscene plays, let's see. Yep.
Only 2 eggs today? Solidus must have taken the day off. 7 8 9 2 5 9 0 3 6 0 3 3 0 5 3 0 5 4 8 8 2 4 6 6 5 2 1 3
What's the situation?
I'm just inside the city limits. This place is crawling with lizards.
Ah, AT Corps' unmanned bipedal weapons, officially designated Irving by the US military. They've spread like wildfire among the PMCs. There are more of those things now in service than tanks. They've got tough armor plating and are highly agile to boot. Your best bet is to stay out of their sights.
Unmanned. Pretty soon they'll have put living, breathing soldiers out of work.
Even so, that's an awful lot of gecko for this scenario. Their numbers exceed the war price for that region. It must have something to do with Liquid's arrival on the scene.
You really think he's here?
You'll have to find the Army's operatives and ask them yourself. Oh, and Snake, I went ahead and used the Mark II to scout out the area before your arrival. You'll find it up ahead.
Mark II?
It's a remote mobile terminal. Sonny and I built it. The Mark II will provide you with a map of the area as well as any battle situation data. You should find it before you do anything else.
Okay, got it.
The rendezvous point is marked on your map. I'll be waiting for you there.
All right, here we go. So yeah, I don't think I get the tranquilizer yet. I gotta go to the rendezvous point first. Let's get a move on. Gotta watch out though, I don't want these guys seeing me. Wait, wasn't there something back here? Hold on a second, let me go back real quick. I think there might have been some stuff I can get around here. Probably from these guys too. Yeah, Metal Gear Solid 1, 2, and 3 are pretty good too, if you've never played them before. They're pretty good games. Ammo, some more rations, sweet. Already got 4. Yeah, I think he could hold 10 in this one. 10 rations. Alright, gotta watch out. I wanna try not to get any alerts, but I don't know. I'll do my best, but I think eventually I'll get caught. More backup for them. Restore psych. Okay, so yeah, the psych is that little meter under the
avoid
health meter.
Avoid unnecessary combat whenever possible. In this war, neither side is your enemy. There's no point whatsoever in you getting into a fight. Got it?
Snake is up on the floor. Alright, gotta watch out. Don't see me, you bastards. Keep going. Damn, there's a guy over there too. Come on, turn around. Oh yeah, go that way. Alright, I think we should be good here. Yeah, he ain't gonna be in Metal Gear Solid 5. The Petro Bomb. Yeah, I don't think I'll be using that if I'm gonna be going for no kills. Let's go down here. I'm gonna try to go for no alerts. Not guaranteeing it. Yeah, I'll wait for that guy to go. That other guy that just shot him. He's around there somewhere. Yeah, there he is. Hold on, I'm gonna hold him up.
Hands up.
You can pick up guns dropped by both the militia and the PMCs. Remember, though, PMC weapons are locked. You can't use them.
Let's interrogate this guy.
If only there was some way to get rid of the locks.
Find what you're looking for.
Oh, it's a trophy? Yeah, the last time I played this game had no trophies yet. So yeah, it's been a while since I last played this game. It's been a long time, actually. I know there's somebody right there. Hope they don't come this way. Anybody else here? Oh, thank God. Alright. We're still not safe, though. Yeah, you can actually get a lot of items just by doing that to the soldiers. Oh, there's a good old cardboard box. Nice. Oh yeah, you know what? Let me go ahead and equip some stuff as well. Let's see, we got... Oh yeah, we got an iPod too. We can actually listen to music as well. Alright, so... Actually, I don't need anything else right now. Oh yeah, we could actually hide on this thing as well. You know, eventually later on, Snake gets a mask, so that way, you know, he could cover up his face as well. That's right, I forgot that happens. Alright, better go. Are you fine? Handle with caution. Nice. Alright, I gotta watch out. I remember that there's somebody
Snake,
up here.
Press the crawl button while running to execute a roll. Rolling can help you dodge enemy attacks and get past small gaps and obstacles.
Who's up? There he is. turn around, you son of a bitch.
Freeze.
You gonna take it or what?
White phosphorus grenade. Okay. Nice. Yeah, that's another way to heal myself as well, to regain bottles. Yeah, I remember that douche over there too. I don't know if I'll interrogate him though, because I think there's somebody else close by as well. Pretty close to that guy, I mean. Here we go. He doesn't see me up here. Where is he? Oh, there he is. Yep, there you go, guys. Humping the floor again. Oh. Okay, let me wait till he goes. What's up, Kevin? And, Gabriel? Yeah, I mean, this game is great. I recommend it, Gabriel. Definitely, man. If you've only played Rising, I definitely recommend it. I mean, it's not going to be action-packed like that game. Well, it's not going to be insane like Rising is, but it's still pretty good. Still a pretty good game. Well, this is where we got to go. Nice.
Snake, it's me.
Huh? Otacon.
Sorry to keep you waiting, Snake. Allow me to introduce Metal Gear Mark II.
Metal Gear?
That's right. Just like Rex. But this gear's not a weapon. It's a remote mobile terminal designed to provide you with operational support.
Where are you?
I'm in the Nomad. Where else? I'll be watching you through the Mark II.
Wish I was good with gadgets.
Hey, I'll be with you in spirit. Anyway, because you had to dress up as a militiaman, I had the Mark II bring you some goodies. Starting with this. Put it on your left eye.
Looks like an eye patch.
I call it the Solid Eye. It's an all-purpose goggle that displays radar images and other data in 3D. You can also switch it over to light-amplifying night vision.
The rebels are out there.
It looks like they've got the government's PMC troops beat, at least in numbers.
And this is their home turf.
Snake, I know this is a sneaking mission, but you'll need to protect yourself.
An operator.
I installed a suppressor. And here's a tranquilizer gun.
How thoughtful.
It predates the implementation of the system. By some miracle, it was never recycled. It's getting tough these days finding decent guns that aren't controlled.
You coming?
Of course. I'll follow you wherever you go, like this. I'll activate stealth so it doesn't attract any attention. If you need it, just bring up the start button menu.
Got it.
Snake, the informants who said they saw liquid here should be a little further up. Head for the rendezvous point. I've placed a mark on the radar in the upper right corner of the solid eye. It's a war zone out there. Stay on your toes.
All right, there we go. So we got the Mark II pistol, the operator, the solid eye, and the Metal Gear Mark II. We can actually use it as well. It's pretty cool.
Snake.
I'll show you guys that real quick.
It's kind of a schlep, but I.
All right.
The Mark II is more than just a communications terminal. It's got a lot of other functions as well. Try taking it for a spin. See for yourself what it can do.
Yeah, it's got stealth as well. I think if any of the soldiers see it, I think it'll count as an alert. But yeah, it can actually knock them out as well. Yeah, definitely. If I go too far, I won't be able to go too far because I'll lose the signal. So I gotta watch out here. Yeah, it's pretty cool. It's got stealth.
Snake, you're about to send the Mark out of range. Watch out!
Alright, I think that's good enough. Let's go back to Snake. What's up, Wolverine? Oh, hold on. Gotta remember. Yeah, I'm gonna try not to go for any kills, so I'm gonna be sticking with that gun. Is there somebody else over here? Sounds like something's going on back here. Oh no, I guess it's just the bullets that are landing. Yeah, I gotta try to avoid being seen here. A lot of explosions in this place. Oh! I thought my buddy's here. I don't know if this is gonna count as a kill, but. Oh, I don't know if I should shoot it. There's an RPG right there. I don't know if it counts as a kill. Nah, actually, never mind. I'm not gonna take the risk. Yeah, because we can actually take out that tank, but. Would it count as a kill, though? That's what I'm wondering. Yeah, I better move on. Yeah, that was the name of that trophy. Hurt me more.
It's pretty dark in there. Switch the solid eye to night vision mode.
Actually, it doesn't look so bad.
Who? Who?
It's me.
Who? Don't move.
Oh, what? Wait. It's... Wait.
You again.
Me.
Go.
Oh. Son of a bitch. Thought that was gonna count as an alert. Yeah, cause I know if you actually help him out and destroy that tank that was outside, they'll actually love you, I guess. But yeah, I'm not so sure if it actually counts as a kill if I destroy it. Wasn't sure about that. I gotta keep an eye out here. There's some stuff we can get as well. Like some noodles. Gotta have our noodles.
Don't move.
Oh my god, really? Are they just gonna keep... Yeah, I don't wanna move, otherwise they might alert them, I think. They will love you. They'll get like little hearts on their, you know, on their heads.
What?
It's Snake, goddammit.
You again.
Oh god.
Go.
It's true, I mean, they'll love you. Oh. Right, some weapons here. Damn. Yeah, they don't stop you like that if you actually help them out outside. Yeah, I don't want to move just in case, you know, when they stop me. Oh, wait. Wait, how do you give them rations again? That's right, you can do that. But how do you do it, though? I don't remember. There we go. What about this guy? I can't give him anything, can I? Yeah, I was like, wait, I remember, that's right, you can actually give him stuff, too. Well, hopefully that'll make him fall in love with Snake. That way they can just let me through without stopping me like that. Oh, here we go. Another iPod song. Yeah, it's mostly like Metal Gear songs and songs from other Konami games as well. Oh, come on, dude. It's me, Snake. Don't you remember me? There you go.
You sure?
Let me through.
Go. What? Don't move.
Oh, God. Yeah, it's been a while. I'm gonna have to give these guys all my rations.
Here.
Don't have to twist my arm.
Who's that?
Thanks.
Are you fucking kidding me? God damn it! Here.
Here.
You sure?
Let me through, bastard.
Go.
I don't know. Maybe I should have destroyed that tank outside. Yeah, there's gonna be some more guards around here too. But yeah, there's gonna be plenty more rations outside. Smoke grenade, all right. Yeah, I remember that there was a song for Police Knots, yeah. Police Knots, Boktai, I think? Pronounce it? Hey, wait, let me go this way. Yeah, here we go. Some more stuff I could get here. Like a Playboy. Yep, those are the books in this game. They're Playboy magazines.
In any case, it's gotta be locked. You can't use it.
Oh. Wait. If I equip that, will they let me through right away? Instead of having to stop every time. Yeah, here we go. Yeah, let me try that. Maybe that'll work. We can get through this place without any problems. Yeah, there we go. Now they shouldn't stop us. Yeah, that's where I was. What the hell? Oh man, I got a feeling I'm gonna have to be wearing this for a while here. Alright, I think this is the part where we meet Chris Tucker from Rush Hour.
Pretty sweet, huh? Oh, hold it. Watch where you're pointing that thing.
Who are you?
Neither enemy nor friend. Voila.
You're not with the militia, and you're not PMC.
I'm a weapons wholesaler. All shapes, all sizes. But there's no need to worry, because all my shit's been laundered.
Laundered?
You see, I take ID guns like the PMCs use and make some mods. Then you can use them without having to match IDs. In other words, I'm a gun launderer. You can call me Drebin.
Drebin?
Yeah, they use that for all of us.
There are more of you?
All over the world. Not that I ever met any of them personally. Me, I'm Drebin number 893. You ain't a registered PMC employee, are you? You need a guy like me. Consider it a welcome gift. Take it. The M4. The official carbine model used by the U.S. Army, developed from the M16 service rifle. This one's a top-of-the-line model, real popular with the big PMCs. High precision, not like that government-issue shit. It's, free-floating, of course. Relax, that barrel's clean.
Is the Hider CQC compatible?
The beauty of this sucker is that it's got a lot of customizable parts. Change it up the way you want to meet your everyday needs.
Flip-up sight, rail system, not bad.
Yeah, well, you know, I get a lot of noobs around here. And if you need them, I got a wide selection of aftermarket parts as well.
The frame's pretty rigid. No rattle.
Go ahead, give her a squeeze.
Trigger.
Really? That's weird.
What's weird?
Wait, I got it. I bet you're using an older generation of nanomachines.
Older generation?
Sometimes they don't really jive with the new system.
Seriously, who are you?
Whoa. Slow down. Oh, yeah. My day job's working at AT Security. I'm in charge of production control. So I get my hands on all the ID chips before they even register. Have a sip. It's a side of AT the public don't see. From the looks of it, you ain't with any state army. But you ain't exactly green, neither. You've got last-gen nanomachines, so I'm guessing former U.S. Army. I don't know what you're here for, but you want to be well-equipped, am I right? So, can we talk business or what? You won't regret it.
What's your take on Emoticon?
I don't particularly like the guy. But it looks like we'll need his help with those ID guns. Sonny's been doing a little sleuthing for us. Drebin, a well-known gun launderer in war economy circles. He's a businessman who deals mainly in selling black market firearms to small PMCs and local militia. Somalia, the Balkans, Lebanon, Darfur, Chechnya, Timor, Peru, the Punjab, Kashmir, Colombia. This guy really gets around.
How's he pull it off, anyway?
You can create a non-ID gun by replacing the ID recognition chip with a counterfeit version. This enables you to bypass the ID recognition process and use the gun. The problem is that there's still a record of the chip being replaced on the system side. Drebin's an employee of AT Security. He must have connections on the inside erasing records for him.
You think the Patriots are involved somehow?
I'm not so sure. If the Patriots were running the system from behind the scenes, then a weasel like Drebin would be a real pain in their collective ass.
Can he be trusted?
Remember, Drebin's a green collar. He makes his living off the war economy. He doesn't let emotions get in the way of business, and he never gets his own hands dirty. The only thing he trusts is money. I share your concern, but what if we keep him at arm's length? Use him only to get intel and the supplies we need. Keep it strictly business.
All right.
So, we ready to make a deal or what? Okay then, let's talk business. This is a war zone. There's product coming in here by the truckload. And you'll be picking up a lot of guns in the field, I'm sure. Whatever guns you don't need, I'll take and buy them off you. That'll earn you points you can cash in for services.
Like what?
I'll launder your ID guns, no more locks. And I can also sell you the guns I've got in stock. Let me show you. To ensure you can use non-ID guns, I'm gonna have to suppress the old nanomachines you got in you. Otherwise, they'll interfere with the system. Here, stick yourself with this. It's full of suppressor nanomachines. Relax, it won't hurt. You're scared of needles or something? Now you can use non-ID guns, no problem. Hey, be nice to our guest. Step outside.
Boo.
See? No problem. From now on, when you pick up an ID gun that says lock, you just let me know. You name it, I can launder it. Of course, it'll cost you. The going rate depends on the war price at the time. Man, I gotta give this shit a rest.
Looks like you're doing pretty well for yourself.
You might say that. What with the war economy and all, and the system clamping down on things. System codes are the law now, and controls essentially absolute, paving the way for fat profits if you're willing to bend the law. Demand keeps on growing thanks to the war economy. I sell ID guns to the PMCs and state armies, and naked guns to terrorist groups and paramilitaries. And these ID guns can't be sold on the black market. System's practically a license for us arms dealers to print money. Privatizing the military's made the PMCs big and bloated. The fatter the PMCs get, the line between civilian and soldier is gonna get real blurry. Sooner or later, the whole damn human race is gonna be green collars. More like, we're all gonna be fighting proxy wars. But hey, this war economy puts the food on my table. You're a green collar too, aren't you? Yeah, it's in your eyes. You've seen a lot of combat.
What makes you think you know me?
Nothing to be ashamed of. I'm the same way. I grew up here too. I got no interest in the outside world. All right then, if you need me, holla. We specialize in speedy service. Catch my drift? I have you.
Smokey! Yeah, they really made that guy look like Chris Tucker from Rush Hour, Friday, The Fifth Element. Really does look like him.
I know what you're thinking, but Drebin does have a point. The world depends on the war economy. Can you imagine what would happen if war just disappeared overnight?
Otacon. You and Drebin both mentioned something about a war price earlier. What did you mean by that?
It's a kind of market price, one that fluctuates according to demand, not only for PMCs and military industry, but for the production, distribution, and energy supply networks that support them. It's been growing by leaps and bounds, and investors are really starting to take notice. As the fighting in any given area becomes increasingly intense and prolonged, the war price goes up. No doubt Drebin's rates are linked to that war price. The longer and bloodier a battle becomes, the higher service prices are going to get. To put it another way, the quieter things are, the better the bargains. Snake, we'll use the Mark II to deal with Drebin from here on out. He's what you might call a street vendor. The Mark II can act as a kind of delivery boy, connect you with him. I'm adding a Drebin menu item to the Mark II's weapon menu. Whenever you pick up multiple units of the same weapon, any extras will automatically be sold to Drebin. Any ammo that's inside gets added to your cash. In other words, you keep the ammo, and the weapon itself gets traded to Drebin for points.
I see.
You can then use the points you've earned to unlock ID guns or buy new weapons.
Sounds good.
We should assume Drebin has other agents collecting guns for him besides you, Snake. You know, freelance green collars who collect weapons in exchange for services?
Guess I'll have to rely on him for now.
Okay. Now go meet up with our informants, Rat Patrol.